This time on Weekend Rental, we play Catacomb Kids, a 2D roguelike action platformer with an interesting co-op mode. Before we get to our reviews, let's take a look at some gameplay.
This episode is brought to you by Five Gum. Okay.
If I can jump in, no.
I think it's a single player one. So yeah. We've got filter on the tutorial.
Yeah, so I'm just checking out the buttons. Got X is the sword, and Y is probably an item that I don't have. Do I need to,
The way these controls work is actually really cool.
Okay, don't have fall damage, which is good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
That's something that always gets me in Spelunky. Double tap, nice.
Yeah, I fall and die a lot in Spelunky.
You know, all this information is truly useful, but at the same time, it's not at all when you get crushed by a trap. Like, honestly, like, like any of the classes, like, all the nuances,
doesn't mean shit. Oh, so you can kind of hold into the right direction.
Oh, and you, like, slide on the wall.
Yeah.
See.
The ghost can teach you things. You can get like little extra moves with your various weapons, which is kind of cool. They all have their various strengths and weaknesses.
You'll learn like different moves if you get good with the weapon.
Yeah, okay.
and the other one means like maybe you'll fuck it up.
You might like backfire or something.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you can. I think you can freeze the.
This like physics stuff. Wow, yeah,
you can
that's
do that.
Really great.
Yeah,
I played a lot of Noita, which is a lot like this, in the sense that there's like elements.
So if you throw that torch ahead, you can kind of see ahead, which is cool.
Nice.
All right, I chose that.
Oh, what's we'll this? See oh, there's like different builds.
The various options under that class that you can use. They've got various strengths and weaknesses. When they hate something, it means that they don't use it as a weapon, but you can throw it, which is actually kind of cool. But things count against you or for you, and if you've got a lot of things counting against you, you'll have more health to start. If you've got a lot of things counting for you, you'll have less health.
Chew five gum. You want to go down
separate?
Here?
I was just wondering, can we separate?
Yeah, you can.
Whoa, okay. Ooh. Oh, and then I died.
Yeah,
because I couldn't see anything.
And now, Philip, since you've died, you are actually floating around as a ghost.
Oh.
There's like a ghost in my house right now.
Can I come back?
Yeah. Try to navigate from where you were from towards where Travis is now.
Okay. But I can't see really because it's off screen.
There's a bar right there that I think tells you.
Oh, here I am. Okay.
Hey, that's my ghostly friend.
Ooh, watch out. I guess I can look ahead. You got a Mario mushroom.
So the mushroom is an enemy.
I'm just coming back.
I'm poisoned.
If you hold down, since you have the sneaky thing, you become like
stealth. Stealth crawl.
Like stealth. Yeah. Like you'll get like all dark around you.
It's hard to crouch walk.
Yeah. But L2 does crouch before it rolls.
Okay, we'll dodge.
Oh, that's a sneaky mouse. Do we kill that sneaky mouse?
Yeah, I think he killed it.
Okay, whoopsie. All right, I caught on fire.
this wasn't in the tutorial. The right stick does this.
That's the Wanderer's special thing.
Cool. What does that do?
Oops.
It just gives you the ability to sort of look around. And if you highlight something, I think it helps you track it. Like,
okay.
Next time that thing's around, it'll.
Oh, there you go.
Oof. Start you right off with an instant kill trap.
Yeah,
that's brutal. Hardcore. How do you throw a Y?
Y stows it, and then B, I think you can throw it. Do you want to get the first? You want to get greens on the leveling orbs, Morty?
Sure.
Fire it up.
How do I grab it? Okay. Hold B. right. I'm gonna go for luck.
So if you guys hadn't noticed before, each attribute that you choose has a different little bonus thing that you can get. I think that you can forgo the little bonus, like Morgie just chose something to where whenever you kill somebody, they drop better loot.
That circle, your eventual return? Wow.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah. Oh, but there were fish you could have killed.
The fish are particularly difficult. Although,
yeah, they seem pretty hard to anticipate.
Yeah. They're psychos. Yeah.
I chose a guy who's good with spears because he kind of auto attacks them or whatever, like into their direction. So you don't have to be super.
It like goes down.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't mean to throw that.
Hey,
the dog comes back naked, it looks like. No weapons.
Wait, wasn't there a.
Is that because Momo ate their own body?
Yeah.
Exactly.
But I mean,
Hold it. You can stow or be holding something else.
Sneaky mouse. I really like the sneaky mouse thing.
Yeah. If you're stowing something, they can steal it from you.
Are you cooking that orc corpse?
Sure looks like it.
Potentially.
Need some health.
Oh, yes, I do. Jesus Christ. Okay. That's what I'm going to figure out. I need a ball of goo. Oh, I've never seen one of those.
Evil.
Yeah.
Goat.
Oh, yeah. Throw that at it for sure. Oh, it's a mana potion.
Oh, did you?
You made it really mad. Oh, nice. You got him with the trap. Oh,
sick.
Wow, that was really cool.
Amazing. Wow. Well, that took care of that.
Then I almost got killed by that boulder. Oh, no.
Oh, what? Great.
Okay, so
that
you can swim.
Cooperating.
Swim around and attack.
If you eat a bunch of fish corpses, you can breathe better. Underwater.
Okay. How that works.
And poison gas.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say your breath starts to smell bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. You shouldn't go on a date. Oh.
Unless you're going on a date with like a cat.
Oh.
Oh. Whoa.
After this, Filter and Neo Sense can jump back in once we fail, inevitably, and they'll have a better idea of what they might do.
There's like random environmental things happening, which I like a lot in roguelikes, like just like an engine that's running itself out. Those platforms are kind of shit, right? Like they
you can
fall through them pretty easily if you're not paying like real close
attention. Is that on purpose? It doesn't seem like it's on purpose. It's because it was going up through like a narrow shaft and that's one thing that I would like to see them work on a bit is just the, I guess, the sloppy handling a little bit.
Yeah.
But that's something fine too. Yeah.
There's some stuff I've experienced in this game where it's like, it's hard to like walk upstairs, like stairs won't work correctly and it'll be like hard to get past like a stair in a hallway area for some reason.
Off.
Where is this time? No.
No, I'm a bully. I'm like stuck. Here we are.
You're gonna die. Oh gosh, okay. You almost got squished, I think.
I don't think
there's any way around this.
That skull at that brazier, it'll get onto that boulder, and then maybe you can knock the boulder into the, see, now it's really hot.
How will I knock it anywhere? I don't want to touch that.
I think you'd push down and hit it.
But I'm afraid
it's already boiling the water. It's already boiling it. You can break your...
You pushed me into it.
Did I push you into it?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
You can grab it when it's up at the top. Now it's fine.
You've got some kind of reflex.
Yeah, well, how did you lift like that? I'm young, dumb, and full of gum. Before you leave.
I did have think time. I was just trying to jump out on that.
All right, one more.
One more.
That's how this game gets you.
Yeah, the jumping's kind of...
It's not great.
I don't love it.
It's like Castlevania 1. I don't feel like I can correct it that much.
It seems out of my hands. I don't feel I'm to blame.
Like, once you hit A, go with God.
Ooh, I like the staircase thing.
Fun mechanic for sure. It looks like you got a hammer of rending player too.
That's me. It's definitely not a hammer of hitting bats.
Nothing really.
I took damage. I'm not sure why.
The boulder probably rolled onto you a little bit.
That was an ice potion.
Yeah.
Identified.
Oh, you're dead.
Yeah, that ice potion that I drank killed me. Obviously.
This hammer does almost no damage.
Chew 5 gum.
It's great.
You're just bad with them because you're a spellcaster. Oh, sometimes they run away, but you can chase them if you want.
What's this fish doing?
It's a fish out of water. It's like hunting fish in a barrel.
I can do
this all day.
Yikes. Cave salt.
You can hear the leveling orb.
I was right next to it, but...
Yeah.
Oh, it's like Joust.
Or that Mario thing.
Yeah, like that.
I got no energy. Okay. That was just round one.
Burned to death.
Brutal.
Jesus Christ, Morgan. Give a man a... you just fucking force pushed me?
Oh fuck.
Relentless.
Yeah!
You deprived him.
Okay.
Can't kill me.
I'm just great axing it.
Yeah, just
great axe with random stuff.
Momo's taking you to a catacomb school right now.
We're just getting started.
Yeah, bad.
Oh, I cut your arm off.
Oh!
Hi.
Young gum. Just like our sponsor. 5 gum.
Young, dumb, and full of gum.
Oh, I like that.
All right, let's hear what our players thought of Catacomb Kids.
Okay, so the game we played today was... Catacomb Kids, and I really like this game. I've been playing it for a while, and it's totally insane in terms of difficulty level. It's not forgiving at all, but that's kind of what makes it good in a way. I feel like this is a game that it's impressive when you're good at it, or sad, one of those, but you know, I think all the downfalls of this game with all the bugs and stuff kind of, I'm sort of able to forgive it because it's just so creative and just so fun, and the versus mode is also insanely fun. Yeah, I think this game is great. I give it a 4. Buy it. Buy this game. Buy Catacomb Kids. It's really good. It's like $5 or something. And I'm gonna kick it to Filter, see what he thought. What did you think, Filter?
All right, thanks, Momo. Yeah, I also like this game. You know, I know it's early access, so I'll, you know, give it a benefit of the doubt for control issues that we saw and a few inconsistencies around like how some of the platforms work. But overall, I think it really brings something unique to roguelike platformers, which is actually kind of a crowded genre right now, I guess, or a category. I always think of Spelunky when I think of like that combination, but this is different enough from Spelunky. You know, there's a lot of complicated interactions and stuff that make it stand out. I did ding it on graphics a bit, and I think most people have. It's got a low-res pixel look thing going on, which is kind of cute, but also it's kind of hard to tell what's going on. I wish the pixel resolution was like doubled, and I can sort of tell how they're making the graphics that low res, where it's paper puppet style animation where things like kind of rotate. So I think, you know, however they're being constructed, it could actually probably be upgraded without redrawing everything. But overall, yeah, I had a blast with it, and I think there's a lot to dig into here as you keep going. So it's got a lot of longevity. Diamond Time, what did you think of this game?
Thanks, Filter. This game for me is a classic. It's wonderful. The from what I understand, it's one person that's working on this thing. I don't know much about them, but I do know that I'm very, very impressed by that fact alone. There's so many little flecks of genius scattered throughout this thing that you keep finding. I even found some tonight, and I've been playing this game for actual years. That said, you know, I do notice some of the bugs and stuff that are around. They seem obvious enough that they should have maybe been addressed, you know, a while back. But I am definitely willing to forgive that. I gave this game points on control. I kind of showered this game with praise throughout, honestly. But the control scheme is difficult and weird to get used to. But I know that, like, in the past when I've played this game more consistently, you start to get to a groove where everything feels very intuitive and just flows. And that's when this game really truly shines, is when you've sort of dedicated quite a bit of time to it. Great multiplayer game. I will say, I wish that there was non-local multiplayer, and I wish that the split screen thing was a little bit better addressed. Whenever somebody walks where it would be off the camera, it's sort of jarring when it switches, and that can lead you to, you know, I mean, there's death at every corner in this game, which is part of the fun. But that seems to be something that I would certainly address, make that a little bit smoother. All said and done, I love this game. 4.5, please buy it. Give this guy your money. Neosense, how about you?
Yeah, so I liked this game a lot. I'm a big fan of roguelike games, especially the more obtuse and confusing. I mean, there's really no other way to call it. It's genuinely confusing when you start a new game like this that has sort of nondescript system or systems that aren't apparent to you right away. Although I knock it a bit on graphics and control, I found this game to be absolutely fun. Rent again or buy on a good sale, because I can genuinely feel that this is the game that would require lots of hours and could become a long-term addiction. It reminds me a lot of Noita in the sense that there's sort of physics and chemical interactions going on in the game. There's a lot of experimentation that can be done. And it just genuinely seems like a really deep, well-made game. Local multiplayer is incredible. When you do the separate screen business, which we sort of address a bit in our review. And the local multiplayer was way more fun than it had any business being for a game in this genre. So yeah, 4 out of 5. It's a great game.